We're here in beautiful Beijing, China, and today we have the XPENG. Now, this is China's first car manufacturer who's been given permission to use L3 autonomous driving within Beijing city limits. And today we're gonna test it out. Before we get started with the test drive, I want to explain the levels of autonomous driving. And if you already know what those are, then skip to the next chapter. It's a beautiful day to be driving around in this beautiful XPENG P7i. This is the same looks as the P7, but with a whole lot of upgrades, particularly to the charging and the self-driving features, as well as some of the other features, which we will put on the screen now. This is the Chinese version of Tesla's FSD. Although China does not use the term autonomous driving, they prefer to use driving assistance. And the XPENG's version of this is called NGP, and that stands for Navigation Guided Pilot. XPENG uses a LiDAR system as opposed to what Tesla uses, which is the visible light spectrum. And both of these have some advantages and disadvantages, mainly in low light conditions or low visibility conditions. Visible light spectrum can impede the ability for the autonomous driving to work correctly, whereas LiDAR cuts through that without any difficulty. We're gonna go ahead and use the NGP system. So we need to pick a destination in our map. We're gonna go to this one here and we are going to choose to use that route. And then, hey, NGP Kaiqi. It started to use the NGP system. So now the car is driving itself and it should follow the map. And so we're gonna test that and see how it goes. Yeah, I think one of the frustrations people will have with this in traffic will be other aggressive drivers, because this car does leave a little bit of space for other drivers to feel like they can go ahead and jump in there. Beijing is probably one of the more aggressive cities as far as driving goes that I've ever been in. Even compared to driving in New York, I feel like Beijing drivers will take any amount of space to get in front of you. It is a little terrifying at times. So as we merge here, I am being pretty careful to monitor the car. I think that my level of trust towards autonomous driving systems is pretty low in general, any autonomous driving systems. So we're gonna have to merge into the highway here in a second. And that's where I feel like there's the most potential for things to go wrong. There's a bus on my right. So we're watching that. Don't wanna hit the bus. Car right now is not sure what to do here. It's just gonna let the bus in front of us. It's probably a good idea. I think it's gonna let all the other cars in front of us now. Okay. The AI here is very generous to other cars. We're gonna try and see if it'll just, yeah, it's just letting all the other cars go. I mean, why not? Let's just let it happen. All right, this is a very... Okay, I'm gonna have to actually take over and go. So, yeah. So now the assisted driver is not on, so I am doing the merge, and I'm gonna try and turn it back on here and see how it does. Okay, here we go. So now it's back on. And it decided it wants to be in this lane, which it's now pulling in front of a bus. That was terrifying. I'm a little, it's making me nervous. It's doing a really good job of going forwards when there's space, but it wants to change lanes every once in a while. And that's what's making me nervous. So right now we need to change lanes. Brilliant. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Okay. So that was the car in front of us was slowly stopping and this car just decided to jerk us to a halt. Now we've got some space. We'll see what the car actually does when things aren't ridiculously complicated. It's changing lanes, doing a good job of changing lanes. I can appreciate that. I have to keep a hand on the steering wheel. The car behind me is very confused about why I changed lanes, but we're good now. All right, and we're going up to speed, 70 kilometers per hour, which in miles per hour is slow, not that fast. I think it's like 50, 55. So we're on the second ring road, now going 81, and the cars ahead of us are not going 81. So this is, This is a little aggressive. That's okay. Feel comfortable still. But yeah, this autonomous driving system, I think, definitely is, it definitely does some things good. It's, you know, the thing about, I think, about autonomous driving is, if it's going to say, like, driver-assisted, should say we're in China, so driver-assisted, not autonomous driving. If it's going to say it's doing work for you, it needs to be very clear about what it's doing for us. Okay, we're changing lanes again. All right. Now we're changing lanes again. This car can't figure out which lane it wants to be in. So I feel like we're just all over. So it's saying, okay, I want to go to the left middle lane. It is very aggressive. The autonomous driving is set at, it feels like a very aggressive scale, which is a good thing and a bad thing. I think it's a good thing in that you have to be aggressive when you're driving in Beijing.
150米后即将退出 NGP.
And it's making the right decision on getting off here, so that's good. In our little jaunt through the city, we encountered three instances where the autonomous driving system did not perform all that well. We were in the outside lane of two lanes, and the inner lane and the outer lane both need to merge and then merge onto the highway. This car just stopped and was letting all of the cars in the inner lane just go ahead, and it didn't really know what to do, so we just ended up letting a bunch of cars through until I finally took over. The second issue came up when there were cars parked on the highway because there was an accident or some kind of emergency, and there was a police car there. A car was merging into our lane, both at speed. When it merged in our lane, our car just decided to put the brakes on hard, which, had there been a car following close behind us, could have created a safety incident or an accident, and it definitely did not feel safe, and I had to go ahead and take over so that we wouldn't just be stopped on the highway. That was just a little bit scary to suddenly have the car braking. It felt very abrupt and unnecessary. The third incident came up where, when we changed lanes, the lane change was very aggressive, and the car definitely goes to try to reach the speed limit quite quickly, which is good. It's smooth, and the lane changes are smooth, but they are a little bit abrupt, and they aren't necessarily logical, as the car put us in the fast lane, then into the middle lane, then into the slow lane, and then it was trying to go into the middle lane when there was a car that was running a little bit slow in the far right lane. I love how Beijing plants trees every couple meters. One of the reasons that Beijing has all these trees every couple meters is because of the history of the Mongols in China. The Mongols planted trees so that in the wintertime, when it snowed, you'd still be able to find the roads, and that history has been passed down from hundreds of years, so they still have the trees all planted along the roads here. It's so beautiful, all those leaves overhanging. Here we go, there's a bus in front of us. Let's see how this goes. Okay, and notice the bus, it's good. It's got a big picture of a bus on there, the LiDAR is working. And we did it, we followed the map correctly there. It's pretty good. Now we got to take the exit ramp and get onto the other highway. The one thing I do like here is it will differentiate between the different exits. One exit has multiple lanes, and this one will choose the correct one. That is definitely a good feature to have. I've definitely taken the wrong exit many, many times. Coming up now, we have cars that are merging, so we're going to test and see how this car deals with having a bunch of cars that are merging. So far, it's just speeding right up to it and braking. And there's a car coming into our lane, and it's kind of okay with it, a little confused. Turning the wheel a little left and a little right. This guy's looking at me like, I don't know what you're doing, and I'm looking at the car like, I don't know what you're doing. No, the car actually handled that pretty well, although it tends to get really nervous when cars are moving in front of it like that. So, like right now, it's giving a little bit extra braking room, whereas since we're in the city and all these cars are trying to shove their way in, it needs to be right up on that other car's bumper. So this car right here is going to need to get in. We are being a little extra generous. I think the programming here is definitely going to need a little bit more work to get this part to where it really feels like, you know, the car is able to do it on its own. I'm sitting here on the edge of my seat while this is happening, and I definitely am more nervous than I would be if I was just driving myself. So, man, every time this car changes lanes, it makes me nervous, but that's not the car's fault. That's definitely me just being a side seat driver. Wow, this car just pulled right in front of this other car. Like, right in front of it. Like, hard right in front of it.
Oof.
We cut that Volvo off hard. They were coming with speed, and we just went right in front of them. That was a little bit rude and terrifying. Driving assistance isn't something that you can really put on an A, B, C, D, or F scale. It either works or it doesn't. And in this case, I would really say it is not quite ready yet. It is a little bit terrifying to use, although it feels pretty good in the instances where it works. But if you can't really trust the entire experience, then it is just kind of scary, and you have to be alert at all times, which kind of ruins the whole reason for doing it in the first place. If you guys have any other cars that you would like to see, please put that in the comment section, and thank you so much for watching.